when a human being is born, he is given the word from the God, have a good life with all pleasantness. Never suffer a single defect, or no harm shall touch you. If anything happens otherwise, I am here with you, speaking to you all the time, that you are deviating from the straight path. The straight path is originating from the mind. Unless there is something in the mind, our body will not function. Our body will not move. Every activity will come to a standstill. So God speaks to you with a word. Do not be suffering from any problem in the mind. We will ask anyone when they are disturbed, what's your problem? The problem is in the mind, not in what happens outwardly. So I will not have any problem in the mind because all good words are there, all the promises are there from God. I am now adhering my mind towards abiding by the God-given promises and words. It is there in our heart. All those words are holy because it is from God. Never worry about anything in this life while you are abiding by my command. When you hear to my words of comfort, there is no other comfort you will require until and unless you change your mind otherwise. The mind level of living is very, very debased one. But the soul level living is giving you the highest form of life, to which you have to ascend to believe it. When God says something to you, it is beautiful, and we admire it, and we long for it. That is the longing time. It belongs to you. Long for it with patience. There comes to you from Allah the energy to withstand the time limit. The understanding ability is increasing, and you will be given with better knowledge, more wisdom, to stand by the commitment. When God has given you something and you have accepted it, the agreement between you and God is over. Now it is all up to you whether you stand steadfast in whatever you have been given as word. The word of promise is the holy word from Allah. Allah means there's none but Him. Nobody can speak inside of you without an element of sound, without hearing from the outside source. There is a feel comes from within. That is the promise of God, which is most suitable to you. You will like it and you will revel it when it happens to you. So believe in the word, and then you follow it up with the things that are happening in the making of that belief. The word is going to happen. Until such time, you will not be feeling any scarcity of your presentness in the mind. Unless you think against using your knowledge, whether it is possible that whatever I am believing will come true, will come to happen or not. This is how we are following our own way of life. With whatever knowledge we have gained from this world, we start believing. That is one type of belief. The other belief is believing in God, who will provide me the provisions for my feel, for my belief, and who will provide me with enough standard of understanding and edge over all the other people of the world to think better and to believe in a greater being. That is the way we want. That is unknown to us, whether it is possible for me to accomplish whatever I have as a feel from God. The feel from God is to be created. It is original. It is unknown to anyone. So it is difficult for you to believe using your knowledge. Knowledge is totally what is created. Your wish is what is to be created for you. I am believing in the wish. I am not believing in the knowledge. But mostly, we believe that things should happen in the way that you feel inside of you. The God-given promise also should happen, that is there in the heart of hearts. At the same time, I reject it because it is not possible using my knowledge, and it is not within my capacity to accomplish it. This is how the tug of war is going, and finally, the more we believe in our knowledge, the more proud we are. Our average to this pleasures of this world is growing greater and greater. We want all things that's created. As much as possible, I want to plunder. I want to squander. I want to amass the wealth of the world. But what you need is life. Life force is what I need. The life force cannot be supplied by all the masses, all the wealth, all the pleasantries that you have around you. It is not going to give you the life force. Life force is what you believe in the highest performance in your life, given to you by God as His mercy and favor. And what you have been used to as living, you don't like it for the next day, because God is always so much benevolent, generous upon the people, that He gives more and more of the fresh nature in life, and He doesn't allow you to culture your nurtured life. We don't want the stale old life. We don't want the same food. We don't want the same climate. We want the changing moments in every aspect. And you are not going to change the climate, atmosphere, environment. Nothing you are going to change, but you will wish for it. I don't want this climate. I want the climate to change. I don't want this hot climate. I want it to change. I don't want this cold. I want it to change. And every moment, God gives you newer and newer input into your mind as need of you. The ultimate need is ever-changing life for the better. How is it possible for us to lead a better life? It is not at all possible, but you want it or you don't want it. I want it. So believe. That belief is the beginning of your life. That belief is the starting point of your holy journey. That is the pilgrimage. The whole life is a pilgrimage. Starts from the induction into your mind that you need such and such life. I want a better life now, but I do not know what betterment I want to place to the existing life that I am following, the existing life I am living. Without knowing, we want a better life. God says, not only a better life, but a greater life. What is better life? What is greater life? Better than what I am living. Greater life means whatever I have not thought about, whatever I have no knowledge about it, but I love that word greater, that is the feel I have. I want to live those life also. Every moment you are given a better and greater life, and you absorb it, you want it, you go about it, but not believing in the unseen, but believing only in the visible knowledge, and whatever knowledge I have gained until this moment, I want to increase in that knowledge only. That I think a greater knowledge, greater achievement. It is not so. God-given knowledge is entirely different. What you possess knowledge is entirely already dead and gone. Don't follow the dead materials. Whatever material you have as knowledge is dead one. It is not going to get for the future. You already dislike the stale old life. You want a better life. You want a changing life and changing moments and changing climate and changing environment. Everything you want change for the better, not the same one you want to live the life like as it existed before. This is how God's word is there in the heart. You know it or you ignore it. You give importance to it or not, it is there in the mind all the time. This is the reason why you are getting better and better. Between the averse to my life in this world and wanting a better life, wishing for it and willing to achieve it on the one side. On the other side, you are not happy with your life, the robotic machinery life, all these days you have been living. Between these two, the things are moving. My life is moving. The more I use my knowledge, the worse I will be feeling about the life in this world. The more I believe in the unseen wisdom, the better I am placed without my knowledge. So the knowledge paves way for the worse life, while the wisdom and belief takes you to a better life. All the time, as long as you are living, God-given promise is there in the heart that takes you to a better living. At the same time, your knowledge proves unworthy to you, but you are proud and arrogant about your way of life, that you are sliding down. Between this, our life is now in a state of tug of war. So we now take the holy trip, believing in the unseen power, that is the word of God, the promise of God inside, always have a better life. If not, you will be sliding down to a bitter life. Never allow yourself from the holy journey to be stopped or hindered by any means, especially your knowledge. Your knowledge is the old, past ways. Then your life to come is the unseen part of life. The world has never seen that which has been given to you as your wish. That wish has come from God. That is wisdom. Wisdom is above knowledge, above all visible things. I believe in my word, in the word that I have received from God. That promise has the wisdom ingrained, inherent. As long as I am wishing for it, that inherent wisdom will take over. Because it's not a visible knowledge, I am leading a life so smoothly without any obstruction to my pleasantness in this world. I will not go after the worldly pleasures, the visible material pleasures, but I will go by the feel, a greater feel, peace. That peaceful life is for the past, present and future. Nothing that I had lost in my life will follow me as grief. What I am unable to do at this moment, but I want it, this incapacity will not give me the worry. And sorrowful tomorrow is not going to be there because I am a believer. That belief gives you the wisdom. That wisdom is unseen. You do not know what you are doing, but you are leading a better life. Now we are not sitting down quietly and calmly because the wisdom part is working. How, you do not know, because it's not knowledge to define it how. We are living instantly and instinctively the 11th hour life. This is the life God has promised you. Every moment, every single second is on the spot decided and given to you and produced for you, because when God says be and it is. Using your knowledge, if you want to know the beginning to the end, how it happens, it is impossible to know that, because you are furthering into a newer wisdom and newer life by the moment. This is the holy journey. Believe and do what you are doing in this world for your day-to-day bread. Do not lead your life of tomorrow using this knowledge. Don't plan tomorrow. You are plotting against your own desire, your own wish. Only the desires are going to take you to the next moment. The desires are whatever you know already, of the pleasures of this world, definitely they are dying pleasures. The moment one is created in the form and shape, the next moment it is dying. We are born in this world as a newborn child, but we are progressing towards our death. Any visible material will die eventually. And if you believe in the deadly part of our life, the consequences will be even more worse for us, and we will be suffering like a hell, that we are as if we are living in a hell. This life is overpowered and outstripped by the will that you still have in the mind. Without your knowledge, you will have that will. With your knowledge, you will have all the worldly desires. Between the two, the greater part of your life is being carried on by the will that you have in your heart, because that is the burning desire. You will say, no, that's the will. That takes you little by little to the better life and greater life. This is the way of the God, whoever has taken to the pilgrimage. During this pilgrimage, you will not resort to any evil, harmful ways. That harmful ways is injurious to your mind, wherein God's word is there. The will even may be destroyed. Thereafter, you will plunge to the abysmal depths of every harm and suffering. Forget about your past and think about your future, how it should be. Already it's given to you from the God as promise. Have a better and greater life. So that portion is still in the mind. For everyone, even if on the deathbed, the next moment I may die, but still I will say I want to live. That is the greater part of life. How much you believe is the question. If your belief is total, then you are given a new lease of life. If your belief is still adulterated and corrupted by your knowledge, whether I will live or not, that settles the life once and for all. So until the last moment, you will have the God-given mercy, the favor, His word, the promise is there, and it takes you to the last breath also. Believe that what you do not know is your life ahead, and believe that what you know already, you are already dead. We lead a life of death and life. We need a life between the living and the dying. And the living force is because it is having a greater power. We are edging towards our future still with belief and some comfort. Often it comes to us. With that comfort, we are progressing our life to further levels. Chapter 2, 197. When you are on the pilgrimage, don't cause harm to your heart. Don't cause dejection to the will that God has placed in your heart. Don't slow down your progress towards your future. Your future should be hale and hearty. It should not be touched by the grievances of your illness. That illness is your weakness. That weakness is your knowledge, the dying knowledge. Our knowledge is forever a dying knowledge based on the material that we have before us. Whatever our superficial sensations, superficial senses feed us is the knowledge. Unless something is there, some particle is there, some visible material is there, there is no knowledge. Whatever you want apart from the belief is the real belief in the unseen, that is wisdom. Believing in your knowledge is one thing that takes you downward. Believing in the unseen wisdom that takes you forward. Fulfilling all your requirements in the process. Believe in the heart. The heart means not the pumping station, but the heart means the mind. Where you feel the relief and sorrow, where you feel than need and hopelessness, where you feel the righteousness and what is the path of error to me. Follow that which is given to you as a target. Your aim should be the target. God has given you, have a pleasant life, that's it, over. That's the target. He doesn't guide you with knowledge and go this way, that way, go this way, that way. It is not so. Then the final part, the aim, the goal, the target is given to you. You want it or you don't want it. You accept it or you contemplate with your knowledge about the possibilities, and then you want to accept it. If you want to throw confusion into the target that I am giving, then you are the losers. I am not to be blamed. Finally, you will need this. When the target time is coming to you, nearing you, you will be very much jittery, very much in need of it. At the same time, you will doubt it, whether it will happen to you or not. So you will be in a state of great suffering, state of great harm that you are casting on yourself. This is the life that most of us are living. Now, from this moment onwards, we will not believe in the visible knowledge, but we will believe in the unseen wisdom. The target is the wisdom. You will be guiding, because the wisdom has its own inherent developing power, creative power, originating power. You follow that wisdom. It is not something seen, it is not something created, it is going to be created for you. The world has not known it, so knowledge part of it is absolutely absent there, and you will be guided by the force, generative force. You will be guided by the creative power of God, and the godliness is now guiding you towards your future, not your knowledge. Don't believe in the knowledge that is visible to the five senses. Believe in something that is not visible to you, because you are progressively moving forward. Knowledge is one thing that you already know. The things that are created, from which you understand certain things. Whatever is created is finally leading to death. Distinctly, it is going to become extinct in short while. And your knowledge, the goal you have in your heart, in your brain, in your mind, that knowledge will give me the better life. Definitely, the knowledge of the visible things take you to the deathward status. Finally, you will become extinct. When the time arrives, you will find no help, no protection for you. Because the knowledge is deathward. The knowledge is all about visible materials that will eventually die. Don't follow the knowledge. On the one aspect, this is the life of the human being. On the other side of it, a wisdom, a generative wisdom, a power that is going to create life. It is going to take you without your efforts on the right direction, with this inherent quality of origination and creation. You are getting a creative life. This is the holy journey all your life. Come to the mindfulness. That mindfulness is, I am aware of the two categories. One is knowledge, other is the wisdom. I will abide by the wisdom, not by the knowledge. I will be willing to see the unseen future blossoming before me as a new generation and power, as a creative original from the godliness. This is my holy life, holy journey. In this journey, I will not entertain my knowledge. Anyone's knowledge, anything that is visible, anything that is seen, anything that is heard, I will not entertain those things. Money is not the criteria, but the belief is the criteria. Belief in the unseen, belief in the wisdom, not in the knowledge and visible things. The things are dead. The things are lifeless. It's not going to give you life, but your belief will give you life. Even the deathbed, my belief will give me life. Life is your source, starting point of all your achievements from God. The more you believe, you are already achieved. The more you believe in the wisdom, the will and wish of God, you are already achieved. The more you believe in knowledge, you are already dead. I have a pain in the arms, I have a pain in the head, I have some difficulty in the vision, I have some difficulty elsewhere, and all the visible materials feed you that you are going downhill as my diseases are worsening. But what Allah gives you in the heart of hearts is the soul is, do not worry. Believe you are going to be all right. I know that I want to become all right, but only thing is I don't believe. I know I want to be all right and I want to be healthy. I don't want to lose my life with suffering, but I want to gain everything before my death. The health maintenance and the health gaining, there are two things. You are maintaining your health, it is impossible. Either you gain your health or lose your health. Using your knowledge, you are gaining. You are losing your health. Using your wisdom, believing in your wisdom, you are gaining your life. There is no in-between. Finally, whatever gains a foothold, that gives you the life, if you believe in the wisdom, has a greater impact on you. If your knowledge prevails over the wisdom, then you are going down in your health. Don't be drowned into sorrow. Be ever growing in the wealth of wisdom so that there is no shortage to your health. Healthy mind is believing in the unseen tomorrow, and tomorrow is not in your hands, so that no knowledge can reach tomorrow. Your studies, your curriculum, your experiences, all these amount to knowledge. This knowledge is not going to give any input for your furthering your life with enough confidence here. With your knowledge, you can only believe things may become okay for you, things may turn in your favor. This is how you can believe with your knowledge. But belief in the knowledge is already a disbelief. Lifeless one, your knowledge about things that is going to be created in your favor or to harm you, you will not know. To our own discredit, we believe in our knowledge and we become proud to destroy us even further. But when God has given you certain amount of fear about tomorrow, your arrogance and pride removes that fear, and you think that with your amassed wealth you can live forever. You can see around you how people having enough wealth, suffering a lot, they don't even want their life. They put an end to their life by committing suicide also. My belief in my knowledge is that I am already committing a harm to me. If this harm grows to a greater stress, definitely I will also commit suicide. Believing in knowledge is like committing suicide. You are already dead. God says, I have given you the knowledge only as a test to see. Your knowledge is all about the dying materials and deadly things. But you want your life tomorrow and you want an unending life. That unending life is your heart. Your life begins from the heart. But we see as our bodily movement, our body is our life. Our activity is our life. Our provisions, material provisions, are our life. Believe that it is your belief that gives you the generative force, that liveliness to you. That has an inherent God's energy, inherent God's power, inherent God's wisdom that is going to create for you from nothing. If you see your life, how it begins, from a small gamut, a small sperm, one single life, atomic life cell, yes. From that you have grown into a six-footer. Before even you were a germ, you were a small part of, unit of your whole entire self. That single sperm cell has so much energy to carry you, to grow you, and to the limits of even 100 years. That energy is there in the small gamete. Before that gamete appeared, you were nothing. But God created from nothingness such a beautiful human race that can live up to 100 years, knowing everything that God has created and understanding what God gives you as a beautiful life ahead of you, and going by the promise, He is steadfast. He will never remove that word from your heart. When He gives you a beautiful life ahead of you, whether you want it or you don't want it, I say I want it. Even now, presently we are aged 40 years, 50 years, 30 years, 70 years, still you are leading a hearty life, healthy life. If Allah asks you whether you want a better life, you definitely say, I want a better life. You want a greater life? Yes, I want it, without knowing. That is the wisdom. Then immediately your energy, your pride follows. I know everything. How is it possible to lead a better life? Is there any better life other than the life I am having all the pleasantries, pleasantness, all the provisions in excess, and I amass so much, there's nothing going to be as loss of provisions for me. As long as I am having provisions, how can I die? How can there be a better life other than this? This is the arrogance. Everything that you are having as material things in this world will be dying. While you will be living, but it is dead already. When you are taking those deadly materials, you become ill. That is harmful to you. The disease strikes you. Now you take only medicines, no food for you, because you didn't believe in the unseen. Unseen is your life. The life cannot be generated by anything, either by the dead material or deadly materials in the shape of, in the form of medicines. It is impossible for you to live with the medicines, it is impossible for you to live with the amassed wealth, because everything is dying. You want a new life. You want something to be created all anew. From nothingness it is to be created. Who will create it for you? If you want to grow your paddy, if you want to grow your grains and everything, then you have to use the material that is already there, the sand, the soil. You have to use your water already there. You have to use your air. You cannot use your air unless the air flows. If there is no water from the heavens, then there is no growth of the provisions. If you take the water from the underground, that's a deadly water, that's a dead water, it is not a moving water, it is not going to give you any life. On the pond, in the pond you can see one day's rain is sufficient, you can see the frogs and the fishes. But in the water that is there below the earth, there is no living material, there is no living organisms, that's a dead water. It cannot give you a lively food. It cannot give you the promise of your livelihood. What you require is life, but what you use your knowledge is a dead material. With the dead material, you cannot provide life to anything. This is how we are using our knowledge to our own discredit. We are using our knowledge to our own detriment. Forget all your knowledge and seek the blessings of God. There you are, edging slowly towards a better life. That better life is a very pleasant life. You are on the holy trip. Never allow the worry and sorrow to touch you any point of time, because your knowledge is supervening, overpowering, because of your pride, outstripping your wisdom. This is how we are to progress from one level to another level. One level of uneasiness to a better level of comfort. We improve and increase our wisdom every day. Is this the way we will be living all our life from this moment onwards? No. We say strong no. I will live by the wisdom, not by the knowledge. I will live by the feel, not by what I have understood and lived through in the material world. Definitely, my life starts with the unseen belief from this moment onwards. I have a heart, I have a mind, I have a life force, I believe in it, but I do not know what that belief is. The belief itself is unseen, that is the power. The belief itself is life. The visible part of the body is not life. I am dying, but I believe I will live. So the invisible part is my life. The visible appreciation of my existing self is not life. So when you are on a pilgrimage, chapter 2, 197, don't involve in what is not good for your mind. The mind is full of God's promises. So don't act in the way to destroy the promises of Allah. Allah means that none but Him, the godliness, is there. And He has given you His word. And that is your life tomorrow. And He is ever considerate, ever compassionate, and is ever favoring you with His mercy, that He keeps inspiring you with His word of betterment to your life, with His word of comfort to your life. That usefulness is, to utilize it or not, is upon us. How much you are greedy over the worldly wealth, how much you are proud about your knowledge, all these things will cater to your destruction. But if you are humble and if you are obedient and if you are abiding by the promises, God loves those who keep up the promise. Forget about your life until this moment, the way and how you have behaved in this world against godliness, or how much you have gotten yourself to a low level of life that you have started feeling for the worst thing to come to your life, not unable to believe in the better things of your life. That is the low status that we have reduced ourselves to. This is the moment we divide the two lives. On the one side, there is no question of believing in the future, except that I believe in myself and my knowledge. On the other hand, I don't believe in my knowledge because the knowledge is dead. I believe in the wisdom of God that He has promised me with a will and wish that has become my longing requirement, need, the provision, the unseen provision. So believe in the unseen is the way that God allows us to keep up. That will give you the nourishment. That will give you the life-sustaining, life-generating power to you. This is the word of Allah, and stick to the promises, that the agreement between you and God when He gave you a better life of tomorrow and you accepted it with all willingness, then that settles the matter. God will not go back on His promise. This betterment, this greater life, your requirement has come to your heart to stay forever. Even in the last moments, this will come up. The God-given feel will come up that I want your life again. Your life is dead. The doctors have told you that you will die. And there's no hope still. That hope is about your knowledge that has come down now. Hopelessness is the result now. Now the livelihood comes to you, the promises of Allah comes to you. Survive. Start living. You have to live. Days are ahead for you, for your life. Now I begin to understand that I need life. Hopelessness is gone, but the belief is now starting. How much you believe after hopelessness? As long as you're still sticking to the knowledge that you have possessed all these years, definitely that hopelessness will continue. Still, Allah's word is there. God is so pure that He will not take back His promise. That will haunt all your life. With a good word He punishes you. Start living. I cannot live. Now the heart is not punished. The heart is in such a state of suffering, a hell-like situation, that I want to live but I cannot live. I want to live with the wisdom, I cannot live with the knowledge. The more you are proud in this world, the more you have braved, you have lived so arrogantly in this world, so much is the suffering towards the end of your life. The life is still ahead of you. God's promise is, you must live, you must live, you must live. That means your life is still ahead. You must still, the lot of life is pending. You must live it comfortably. That is the reason why I allowed to live for the longest period. I have suffered all these years. Now I want to live for a longer period. At the age of 90 years, I want to live for the longer, for a still longer period, because so much I have suffered, so much I have to gain. God's word is that you must gain and complete your life according to the agreement that has happened before, maybe between you and me. I gave you my word that you must lead a comfortable, beautiful life without any shortage of any pleasantness in this world. You agreed to it, but at the same time, you threw it behind your backs and started living your life in the way that people are living, and you felt proud in that also, but now you want to live. So when I die with that feel, with that feel of not having my life any further, hopelessly, that is the time I am dying without honor. God says, don't go to that extent. Don't spoil your mind. Don't underestimate what is given to you as a promise from me. My promise will stay to haunt you forever. When you are on the deathbed also, my promise will be there. You must be living. That is the day you lost all your hopes and beliefs. There is no point in believing now that things have reached a low stage and you will be dying without any honor before Allah. These are the despised souls which will reach the hell eventually. You are living by your mind. You are living by your heart. Not by your body and materials that you have possessed. Not by your knowledge, definitely. The knowledge is about the past. The wisdom is about the future. Believe, there is no self-confidence, there is no hope, except the belief that God's promise will stand true. Don't speak unnecessarily one to another, disrespecting the will of God. That's also there when you are on the holy trip. When you are on a holy journey, when you are on the belief journey, 2187, don't use evil words. Don't impart your knowledge to another person. Don't try to undermine the hope, the belief that they have. Don't try to discredit a person who lives by the belief. And stop bothering about others, thinking about others, and casting slander against one another. Don't backbite on each other. Each one has his own faults and errors for which he must be accountable. So let him fear God, that his accounts will be on the harmful side, will be removed. Whatever I have earned as my own evil must be done away with. It is also a belief. God says, all your harmful deeds and acts, all your sins, all your wrongdoings must be removed. And you believe, yes, all my sins must be removed and I should not be accountable for my own wrongdoings. That evil nature will be removed by God if only you believe in it. So at the same time, Allah says that you will be receiving my favor in abundance if only you seek forgiveness for your mischievous behaviors. The mischievous behavior is that I don't want another person to come up in my life. While I am at fault, I don't want to correct my fault, but when other people, because of their wisdom, because of their vision, will, when they are growing up by the grace of God, I am feeling jealous about them. That envy is the greatest evil, that Allah despises the soul altogether, that there is no way of, even the hope will take them to a little, a life ahead of them, with suffering also. They will be worse, in the worst situation, they will be suffering, and they will be wanting to life, wanting to lead a life, even in this suffering, with more harm also. That is the despised status of any soul. Any person who is suffering will not want to live, but these people who are suffering, they want to live even for a longer period. Even they can be amputated here and there, and still they want to survive. They think that this medication is making me survive for a long period. Even lying in coma, still breathing, they consider it a life, and that life will also be counted as the longevity in their life. So, if you believe that your sins must be erased, it is God-given message to you. Your sins are now overpowering you, overwhelmingly affecting you. Seek forgiveness from Him. But your pride will not be able to listen to that call, and you will not be able to understand where is the crime that I had done, how can it be removed, how can my crime can be a platform that I am living on the on a period in which I am finding so much of disturbance, so much of suffering, so much of illness, and nothing good I am seeing around me. Where is the possibility of seeking forgiveness? They will ask forgiveness, at the same time they will not believe in the forgiveness. God-given promise will always be there, but you will be rejecting it. Your own rejection will be sufficient to prove that you are a sinner and you are fit for all the sufferings to come in the near future from this moment onwards. It's not a warning, but it is happening around us. See around you how people are suffering with all their wealth, with all their knowledge, finally dying in the hands of the people who say that they are the saviors of their life, that is the medical people. You have to die by your own methodologies that you had adopted, and in the hands of the people who claimed that I will save your life. We are your saviors, not God. Believe not in God, believe in the scientific advancement of medications and medicines, and believe in us equal to God, and we are here to save you, and you will die in their own hands. Before that, you will be tortured, you will be operated, organs will be removed, you will be maimed, you will be truncated, finally put to death, and before dying, they will steal your organs to implant it on another person. And thus the evil and harm spread all over the world. In every human being, it is there as their knowledge, because they are seeing. Sometimes they believe, that becomes their knowledge. Seeing is believing. They die also, you are seeing. Whoever claims to save your life, they cause death to you, that also you are seeing. But you see at that point of time, it's God's wish. No. God's wish is there in, you see, in a dying patient, he wants to live further, that's God's wish. But you are dying now, you are causing death to yourself. At the time of death, if I am peaceful, I am saying only I am returning to God. That means you have reached the end of your life. By God's promise, you had led your life so peacefully and beautifully, truthfully, to the point to which God has appointed for you. When the term comes near you and touches you, you will be happy to go. But when you want to live, you are dying at the hands of the people who claim that they will save your life, and you believe them not in God, you believe in knowledge not in wisdom, you still want to live, but you die. Your soul lives in a despised state for hell. Please understand, those who are dying still want to live, but they die. They are not led a good life. Their life is full of miserable situations, occasions, and they lived a life of a very, very substandard abasement, abased life. This debased life, the mean life, the miserable life we don't want. Whoever wants to live but dies, they have committed a self-destruction. It is a suicide which is not allowed in any religion, which is not allowed by anybody. It is not accepted by the human standards, because God's standard prevails there. He has died a death at an inappropriate time when the life is still ahead for his forgiveness and for a better life and greater life, he has caused the death so early because of his miserable standards in adopting knowledge as his life. Abide by God's wish and will, and your life will be much pleasant. It will be a better life towards the greatest life that Allah has promised you. And when that life is achieved, when the death arrives, you will be very peaceful to accept it. And your life departs, your soul departs as a peaceful soul. There the soul rests in peace. Not because of you saying, may his soul rest in peace, he is going to rest in peace. And it is not with you. It is not in your judgment. It is not in your power to cause your soul to rest in peace. So never speak such unnecessary words. Don't waste your time while you are living in this world. When God-given message is there, you will be living your life until the term appointed for you arrives. You will be still, when the appointed time comes to you, you will not be sorry for it, but you will be gracefully accepting it. But at that point of time, when you want to live further and you die, nobody can stop you from destroying yourself, because you are already hopelessly destroyed. The self, the intelligence, the wisdom, God is removed from you, and you will never be grateful in your life. All the years of your good life, you had thought that because of your preservance, because of your knowledge, and because of your standard, you have lived until this far, and God has no place in it. Everything was in your powers that you lived. That is sufficient harm, that is sufficient wrongdoing, evil on your part, that finally your soul lives in a despised, degraded state. So believe in God now, believe in his wisdom, believe in his word, and believe in his promise that you lead your life towards an unseen future. Visibly before you it is there, because I want to live a future. This is unseen but certain. With your knowledge, it is so uncertain, but still you believe. Finally, you will lose your life hopelessly. So chapter 2, 197 reveals to you that you will not spoil your mind by projecting your knowledge about the wisdom of Allah. And don't speak about others any evil thing, except the good messages that you can communicate between one another. Do not use anything using your knowledge and giving false hopes and promises that do this, you will be all right, do this, you will be prosperous. All those things will never be communicated, exchanged as means of life, as means of help between one another, but speak to them the belief and God, the belief and the wisdom, the belief and the certainty of your beautiful future. All these things will cater to you, will pave your way towards a better, beautiful, greater life.